Like Max Duggan, very highly recruited. He was a five-star recruit. He hands it off. They bring one straight up the middle. Donovan Edwards might go. They wrestle him down from behind.
They wanted to do here with their formation.
And it's Philly special, their version of it. Loveland broke a tackle, but he's in trouble. Colston Loveland stopped back at the 9-yard line. J.J. McCarthy throws, and it's intercepted. Touchdown by Bud Clark.
Major college football news yesterday. Michigan coach Jim Harbaugh negotiating a 4-game suspension with the NCAA for recruiting violations that date back to the COVID recruiting dead period imposed in March of 2020. Now, 4 games is a third of the season, but you ask yourself, how much will they miss Harbaugh? And the answer is, well, probably not that much.
I'm living in that 21st century, doing something mean to it. Do it better than anybody you ever seen. Do it. Got a nice ring to it. I guess every superhero need his theme music. No one man should have all that power. The clock's ticking. I just
touchdown, Roman Wilson.
Stop tripping. I'm tripping off the power. Broken, the school's closed. The
ball straight up the gut, touchdown.
Lose, motherfucker, we rolling. Motherfucker, we rolling. With some light skinned girls and some Kelly Rollins. And this white man world, we the ones chosen. So good night.
Throws and completion on the run. Roman Wilson.
I see you in the morning. This is way too much. I need a moment. No one man should have all that power. The clock's ticking. I just count the hours. I'm tripping off the power. Till then, fuck that, the world's ours. Fuck this Chanel and the whole cast. Tell them Easy said they could kiss my whole ass. More specifically, they could kiss my asshole. I'm an asshole. Niggas thoughts is Napoleon. My furs is Mongolian. My ice brought the goalies and I embody every characteristic of the egotistic. He knows he's so fucking gifted. I just needed time alone with my own thoughts. Got treasures in my mind but couldn't open up my own vault. My talent, like creativity, purity and honesty is honestly being crowded by these grown thoughts. Reality is catching up with me. Taking my inner child, I'm fighting for a custody. But these are possibilities that they entrusted me.
Time for McCarthy. Now he wins it downfield. To the end zone, Roman Wilson. Who's got a touchdown?
Stop chipping, I'm chipping off the powder. Peel in, fuck that, the world's ours. Translation with a whole fucking nation. They say I was the Obama nation of Obama's nation. Well, that's a pretty bad way to start the conversation. At the end of the day, goddammit, I'm killing this shit. I know damn well y'all feeling this shit. I don't need your pussy, bitch, I'm on my own dick. I ain't got a power trip, who you going home with? How ye doing? I'm surviving. I was drinking earlier, now I'm driving. Where the bad bitches, huh? Where you
First and foremost, congratulations to Michigan. They're as good as advertised. That's. I said this on the radio a second ago. I think they're the best football team I've seen in 11 years of being a head coach. I've never seen a football team like that, that deep. I'm not sure if this is true, but I was told this walking off the field. They could travel 75 people. They've played like 74 of them. I don't know. I mean, they're one of the deepest teams, one of the best teams, one of the biggest teams, fastest teams, strongest teams, and they do not make mistakes. They are truly like a boa constrictor.
Intercepted.
Death. Jumping out the window. Letting everything go. You got the power to let power go.
McCarthy out of the pocket. Oh, he just pitches it. Edwards.
Oh, up at Michigan.
Oh! Michigan.
I mean, there's been some interesting stuff happen to this Ohio State team from Michigan the last couple of years. You know, more specifically last year coming in here. They're saying it's not just this year this has been happening.
Whoa.
They said this has been going on for a while. Stealing signs. My thing is, I think everybody is trying to steal the other team's signs in football, in any sport that is competitive. It's kind of an unwritten rule. If you're going to give us that advantage, we're going to take it. So whenever they start saying, well, it's much more than that, and it's like something that's punishable and everything, and they're investigating it, you would have to think that it would involve something deeper. Like for the Astros, it was the trash cans.
And the exoskeleton on.
For the New England Patriots, it was they were filming them and then breaking them down.
Smart.
And it's like certainly a step above what everybody else morally was willing to do.
But the NCAA is investigating Michigan, where a staffer allegedly scouted future opponents in person at games, which would be a violation of NCAA rules. A lot of people are weighing in on this. Among them, yesterday, Colorado coach Deion Sanders. Listen.
You could have someone's whole game plan. They could mail it to you. You still got to stop it. You still got to stop it. So in football, it's not as pronounced as baseball. If I know a curveball is coming, I got you. You know, with football, I don't give a darn if you know a sweep is coming. You still got to stop it. Physically, it's a physical game. You got to stop it. So that's a little tough. I don't buy into a lot of that stuff that someone's stealing this, stealing that.
Like, this thing has gotten ridiculous. I mean, first of all, we all played this game for a long time. Every team is stealing signs, right?
Trying to.
And every team's trying to steal checks. They're listing the TV copies about, you know, how quarterbacks are audibling. They're listing all this in the meeting rooms. Like, all of this information you're trying to gather, you understand as a football player, is happening. And every team is doing it. And so that if one team is getting singled out, it's just nonsense. Like, at the end of the day, what Deion is saying is 100% true. It is a game about physicality. It don't matter what you know. It's can you stop it or can you execute it?
Breaking news out of college football, where Jim Harbaugh has agreed to serve his 3-game suspension for the Big Ten as part of the Michigan sign-stealing scandal. The Big Ten investigation is now closed, but the NCAA remains ongoing. In a statement, Harbaugh said he decided to accept the sanction to return the focus to the Wolverines' on-field product. He'll be eligible to return to the sidelines for the Big Ten title game and college football playoff should Michigan be selected.
Michigan.
to say that this has been a crazy 24 hours for your guys to win on the road in this environment when there were doubts. Jerome, what does it mean to you?
Well, I thank the Lord. Well, I thank Coach Harbaugh. Love you, man. Love you, man. This is for you. For this university, the president, our AD, we got the best players, best university, best alumni in the country. Love you guys. These guys right here, man. These guys did it, man. Talk to him, man. Love you.
Calling you all types of names, but we stand strong and we stood together as one, and we came up victorious.
your offensive line leader, Zach Zinter, goes down. You guys respond emotionally right away. What did that mean?
You know, that's one of the guys that came back as well. You know, so when I scored, I threw up the 6-5 for him. We said we were going to do it for him, and we did it. You know, Zach, heal well. You know, get, I know you'll be back stronger than ever.
He said, I promise, I'm going to make a play. And that's what Roman did. We all had faith in him. We all believed him. You know, he was just playing hard, you know, and things happened. You know, I love my guys. I love my guys. I don't really know what to say right now. I'm just blessed. I want to thank God for just allowing me to be here. This time last year, I wasn't here, you know, so I just want to thank God, you know, full circle, full 365, and I'm blessed.
All right, we will see you in Houston.
It is a delighted trophy stand here as the Michigan Wolverines are the college football playoff national champions. The offensive player of the game tonight from Michigan is Blake Corum. Blake, you guys were able to set the tone early. You ran for more yards in the first half than Washington had given up in a game all season. How do you think that set the tone for the rest of the night?
Oh, we knew we needed to set it early. The offensive line, shout out to y'all, man. Shout out to the tight ends and receivers. Y'all really killed it today. Michigan, we did this for you.
Now that this moment's been realized, how does it compare to what you imagined it would be?
This is everything I imagined. When we said to come back, it was a lot of us. We said we had unfinished business. So I'll leave y'all with this. Business is finished.
The business was indeed finished. Over 100 yards tonight. Found his way to the end zone repeatedly as he has throughout his career. Now let's talk, if I can find him, the head coach of the Wolverines, Jim Harbaugh. Hey, Jim, congratulations. I heard you tell Holly Rowe that each one of these pieces of confetti had a story. What story are these confetti pieces telling right now?
It was a journey, a spiritual journey. This took counsel from God, the Holy Spirit, this team, everybody, unanimous support for each other. I ain't got a question, but my dad does.
Jack Harbaugh, what's your question?
I have a question. A question, if I may. Who has it? Us? No!
What does this mean, Jim, to be able to share this? Those look good on you, pal. Those look good on you.
Will Johnson, too.
What does it mean to be able to share this with your dad, your brother John, here at the Jesus Pinnacle for a university and a place you love?
Yeah, I just want to say, through my two great loves, my family at work, this team, and my family at home, I love you. I love you. Congratulations.
Jim, when you think about what your mission was when you came back to Michigan, Michigan man, which just means so much to you, what does this mean for Michigan football big picture, the modern era, the first undisputed championship?
15-0. This is a spectacular team, and I would just say there are over 100 Michigan men that are on this team in uniform tonight. And what they've done the last 372 days is amazing. They're champions, simply known as national champions. Pull it down! Pull it down! We did that! We did that.
Did it indeed, and to the victor, the spoils, Bill Hancock. That's it. Jim, you might want to stick around for this part. There it is. They won't pull that down. Chris, as they say in Ann Arbor, conquering heroes, victors valiant, Michigan. National champions for the 2023 season. Chris.